When we talk about the Flash and how fast he can run, are we talking about speed, velocity, or both? In this video, I'm going to talk about the difference between speed and velocity and what it all means for the Flash. Hi there, I'm Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist, and on this channel, you'll find videos on the science and engineering behind superheroes and their superpowers, as well as other topics. If you're new here, please consider subscribing and ring the bell so you get notifications on the latest videos. Right, let's get into it. The Flash, or Barry Allen, is the fastest man alive. Well, that's what he claims anyway in the opening credits of the Flash series from the CW.
My name is Barry Allen, and I am the fastest man alive.
Steady on, Barry. Self-praise is no praise. When the Flash refers to himself as the fastest man alive, is he talking about his speed, his velocity, or both? To answer that question, we need to take a closer look at speed and velocity. First of all, let's take a look at speed. First thing to keep in mind about speed is that speed is a scalar quantity. This means that speed has no direction. Other scalar quantities include temperature and mass. How do we calculate speed? Speed can be calculated from distance and time. If you know the distance that an object has traveled and you know the time that it took to travel that distance, you can calculate the speed. Right, what about velocity, and how is velocity different to speed? Well, velocity is a vector quantity. This means that velocity has got a direction. Other examples of vector quantities include displacement and acceleration. How do we calculate velocity? The formula to calculate velocity is not that different from the formula to calculate speed. It's just that one quantity in the formula is different. The formula for velocity is displacement over time. In this case, displacement is how far an object has moved from its starting point to reach its end point. It's not the total distance traveled by the object. That's the difference between speed and velocity. In the Flash TV series, we routinely see the speedsters such as the Flash, Jesse Quick, Kid Flash, running around the particle accelerator at Star Labs. To explain the difference between speed and velocity for the Flash, let's do a little calculation involving the Flash running. But let's not look at him running in a particle accelerator. It's time to hit the track, the running track. Right, so we're at the track and we're going to do a little bit of an experiment here with the Flash and have him run a lap around the track to explain the difference between speed and velocity and what it all means and how we can use the formulas. Let's get the Flash to complete a lap then. So the Flash is at the starting line, at the start position, completes one complete lap and ends up back at the start position. So the start position and the end position are exactly the same. In this case, speed is distance divided by time, and the distance of an Olympic running track is 400 meters. In this particular case, the time that it took him to travel that distance was 1 second, which would mean his speed would be 400 meters per second. To put that in perspective, the speed of sound and air is 343 meters per second, which means that the Flash's speed of 400 meters per second would be Mach 1.16. In the Flash series, you regularly hear them talk about the Flash running at Mach numbers, which refers to multiples of the speed of sound. Now, what about velocity? How does that change when we start thinking about the Flash's velocity on the track? Let's take a look at the velocity of the Flash when he completed one lap of the track. Just to remind you, the Flash ran from the start point to the end point, which happened to be exactly the same. Velocity is calculated from displacement divided by time. Now, his displacement in this case is the distance between his starting point and his end point. And in this case, it's actually 0 meters. And regardless of how long it took him to complete this lap, which was 1 second, his velocity will be a confusing 0 meters per second. Wait, what? Zero velocity? That doesn't make any sense. But actually it does, because as the Flash completed one lap of the track, his start position and his end position are exactly the same. That means his displacement is zero. This can also be explained by thinking about how his direction changed when he moved around the track. As he completed one complete lap of the track, he actually ran in every possible direction, and they all cancel each other out. So when he goes from the start back to the start, his direction hasn't changed at all. But how can we measure a non-zero velocity? To do so, we need to change the calculation and the measurement and try to find an instantaneous velocity. To calculate the instantaneous velocity of the flash, what we're going to do is we're going to zoom in on a section of the track, in this case one of the straights, and we're going to set up a couple of detectors to be able to measure the flash's velocity. Here's the zoom in on that particular section of the track, and we've set up two particular points, P1 and P2. They're 8 meters apart, so we know the distance that the flash will travel between these two points. And when the flash passes by P1 and P2, we'll note the time at which he passed those particular points. You can do this using a number of different technologies. You could use a radar gun, you could use a light gate, you could even use a radio frequency identifier. And when we do this, we will then have the times at which he passed P1 and P2, and we'll know the distance or the displacement to go from P1 to P2. As a result, then we can calculate the velocity, knowing his displacement and the time between P1 and P2. In this case, the displacement was 8 meters, and the time between P1 and P2, well, that was 0.0195 seconds. If we put all that information together, we find that the flash's velocity is 410.25 meters per second to the left. It's really important that you stipulate the direction of the flash. If this was on an XY coordinate, you would say that the flash's velocity is minus 410.25 meters per second, because the minus there gives you a direction on an XY coordinate if you were talking about this in terms of mathematical notation. That speed and velocity, and just some of the mind-boggling speeds that the Flash runs at in the Flash TV series. But what are the limits of the Flash's speed?
Barry, to make that jump, you'll need to go Mach 3.3, but only for a second.
Yeah, I'm also doubting that you can actually reach Mach 3.3, Barry. Reaching Mach 3.3, it's just a little bit unbelievable, to be honest, for a whole bunch of reasons. Depending on the DC source, whether it's a comic book or a TV series or a film, you'll find that, well, Barry Allen has no limits to the speeds at which he can run. And all of the crazy physics and repercussions of Barry Allen running at these speeds are all nicely explained away by the speed force. Speed force? What's that? Well, in the Flash TV series, speedsters like The Flash, Jesse Quick, Zoom, Godspeed, all have their powers of speed thanks to the speed force. Disclaimer, the speed force does not exist. In some comic book content, The Flash is even reported to be running faster than the speed of light. In fact, 10 times faster than the speed of light. This is quite similar to a tachyon, which is a particle that is always traveling faster than the speed of light. Disclaimer, tachyons are fictional particles. The speed force is a whole other topic, and perhaps I'll get into the details of the speed force and the real or not so real science in the speed force in another video. And finally, the answer to the question, when we talk about the Flash running, should we talk about speed, velocity, or both? Over short distances, or when the Flash is running in a straight line, it's a good idea to talk about velocity, because you can measure his velocity or instantaneous velocity using radar guns or even light gates to measure the time it takes for him to run between two points. And of course, you can also stipulate the direction in which the Flash is running. But when the Flash is running between two particular points of interest and you want to know his speed between those two points, taking into account all of the distance that he has run, it's best to think about average speed. I hope you've enjoyed this video in relation to speed, velocity, and the Flash. If you want to see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to get notifications of the latest videos. I've been Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist. Thanks for watching, And until I see you again, always think super.